Well, time is getting away from us here, but at the Temple of Merneptah in Egypt, or in the area of Thebes, was made an important discovery back in 1890. This stela, which we call the Merneptah stela, dates to about 1210, and it's the only mention of Israel in Egyptian records. And so this is recording a campaign into Canaan by Pharaoh Merneptah, son of Ramses II, and it mentions here that various cities were captured and Israel is wasted, he says. First mention of Israel in a document outside the Bible. So we know that Israel was in the land in 1210 BC, and that they were well enough known so that the Pharaoh of Egypt would brag about having defeated them. Well, this is just a little bit, a few decades after the destruction of Hazor, which I didn't mention was the largest city in Canaan. And so Israel had gained power now and strength. They defeated the largest city in Canaan, and they were known by the Pharaoh of Egypt as the major power in Canaan at this time. Well, that changed in the next century when the Philistines came in, but in 1210 BC, they were the most important power in the region. Well, there are some reliefs here at the Karnak Temple in southern Egypt, which apparently are depicting pictorially that campaign into Canaan. We don't have time to discuss all of these reliefs, but it seems that it's depicting the very places mentioned in the Merneptah stela. And this one scene, unfortunately, only partially there, seems to be a depiction of the Israelites. Again, we lack the inscription that would tell us who this is, but it appears to be a depiction of the Israelites in 1210 BC. Well, at Shechem, we have more evidence to support the story in Judges chapter 9 of Abimelech, which means my God is king. Most people say Abimelech, but it's Abimelech, son of Gideon, who took over as king for some 3 years. And we're told that he gained the support of the elders here at Shechem and had some interaction with the people there, and eventually they turned against him. A temple is mentioned in that story, and the temple has been excavated. A gate is mentioned, the gate has been excavated, and in the account, there was a great fight that took place at the city of Shechem, and Abimelech actually burned the city and sowed it with salt. We have the evidence there of a great destruction. And there's a quote from the excavator. We won't read that. Finally, at Dan, we have a story toward the end of the book of Judges in chapter 17 and 18 of how the tribe of Dan migrated from their tribal allotment up to this place, which was originally called Laish, and they changed the name of the site to Dan. And in that story, we read how they burned the city with fire, burned this site of Laish, and then named it Dan. And the excavations there indeed have shown that it was burned by fire around 1175 BC. And we have not only that, but evidence of connections with the Sidonians in this tomb, lovely imported pottery, probably came through Sidon. Mentioned several times here in Judges 18 about the connection with Sidon, and we have here the destruction, description of the destruction, and also many large storage jars were found there in the next layer of the people who had destroyed the city. They settled down as squatters, and they had these very large storage jars, and they weren't made locally. They were brought from elsewhere. And these are hallmarks of Israelite settlement and activity. And so that shows that the people who destroyed it came in from outside and probably are the Israelites. Once again, we have the right material culture there. It's in the right place to verify that that story in the book of Judges really took place. The excavator, Abraham Baran, who died just recently, just a month or so ago, sadly at 94, He believed it was the Israelites who destroyed that particular level and who settled there, and he believed in the truth of that particular biblical story.